Hi guys! Good morning! Magandang umaga! Buenos dias namas y caballeros! We are your fellow criminology students from Group 1 and we are going to share our knowledge regarding the content and contextual analysis of selected primary sources in the Philippine history. And if everyone is ready, let me welcome you to the World of Paintings, the works of Juan Luna and Fernando Amorsolo. But before anything else, what is history paintings? It is a visual presentation of concrete happenings on the life of people in a specific language. It is the idea of certain events and people is communicated or expressed aesthetically through art with form, technique, and style. Essentially, these paintings are instrumental to the visualization of the reality which stands equally with text, photos, caricature, and films. We, the students of history, will be exposed to determining and seeing the balance between history and imagination. The artwork itself will be explored and examined as how it shows the reality contextually. Now let's start with our first painter, Juan Luna de San Pedro Inovicio Ancheta. He is a Filipino painter, sculptor, political activist of the Philippine Revolution, maestro, hero, and a hot-headed person. But he was the first Indio to show Europe that our ancestors were not savage or unmannered people. Juan Luna is best known for his impressive rendition or performance of classical subjects in his classical works. These works include historical scenes and portraiture. However, subsequently, he turned to realism, depicting social inequalities. Aside from Juan Luna, almost every Filipino young man was dreaming about going to Paris. Because according to the historians, nearly everything a young man could want was there. Ang oportunidad na sumikat, makapag-aral, at maging isang babaero. At that time, Paris is known as the land of opportunity and sex capital of the world. And now I guess we're ready to tackle about the most famous painting of Juan Luna, the Spoliarium. Spoliarium is a Latin word referring to the basement of the Roman Colosseum where the fallen and dying gladiators are dumped and devoid of their worldly possessions. When we say gladiator, it is a man trained to fight with weapons against other men or wild animals in an arena. At the center of Luna's painting are fallen gladiators being dragged by Roman soldiers, while on the left, spectators ardently await their chance to strip off the combatants of their metal helmets and other armory. In contrast with the charged emotions featured on the left, the right side meanwhile presents a somber mood. An old man carries a torch, perhaps searching for his son, when a woman weeps to the death of her loved one. Luna spent 8 months completing the painting, which depicts dying gladiators. The painting was submitted by Luna to the Exposición Nacional de Bellas Artes in 1984 in Madrid, where it garnered the first gold medal. Next to Luna's work is the Parisian life, also known as Interior d'un Café or Inside a Café. This is the period in Luna's career in painting known as the post-academic or the Parisian period. It is a time when a style moved away from having dark colors of the academic palette and became increasingly lighter in color and mood. One of the masterpieces that Luna created when he stayed in Paris, France, from October 1884 to February 1893, almost 9 years in the making. The painting is the only one among the hundreds of Luna's paintings wherein the master painter painted himself as part of the painting's narrative, regarded as the last major work he did during his post-academic and life in Paris because from 1894, Luna traveled frequently that he was only able to paint a few number of landscape in the Philippines. Parisian life has a playful and relaxed mood that does not provide the slightest hint of the stormy happenings to come in Luna's personal life. makikita sa kanyang ipininta ang isang babaeng nasa loob ng isang cafe. Ang babaeng ito ay isang prostitute at nagre-representa ng mga fallen womanhood. Siya ay aktong tatayo na sa sofa na kanyang kinauupuan. Makikita rin sa kaliwang bahagi ang tatlong lalaking animoy customer din ng masabing cafe. Kung papansinin natin maigi, ang pagkakaupo ng babae ay nagmistulang mapa ng isang bansa. Ang kanyang mga braso ay nagre-representa sa Palawan. At kung hindi pa rin malinaw sa inyo kung anong bansa ito, ito ay walang iba kundi ang ating bansang Pilipinas. And yes, that lady is our motherland, the Philippines. She was wearing pink and white to symbolize the purity of the country. But her suggestive sitting position depicts the abuse from its colonizers. Its black turtleneck, which people believe to be a rope pulling the woman up. She was being hung, and for experts, it symbolized the lack of freedom of the country then. Pinaniniwalaan din ng mga eksperto na ang babaeng ito raw ay maaaring may kasamang Espanyol. Sapagkat kung titignan natin maigi, makikita natin ang sombrero at coat sa tabi nito. Makikita rin sa kanyang ekspresyon ang mga tinatagong kalungkutan. The painted illustration captured the gathering of three significant personas and heroes in the Philippine history having a discussion about the Philippines. Ang tatlong lalaking nakadamit gaya ng kung paano manamit ang mga Espanyol, ang coat at cap ay walang iba kundi sina Luna, Jose Rizal at Ariston Bautistalin. The three gentlemen have embraced the Western lifestyle while remaining passionately Filipino at heart. In the larger context of history, Parisian life is therefore also a significant work, capturing a last gathering of great Filipinos on the eve of momentous events. Next on the list is Fernando Amorsolo. He is a painter of rural landscapes. He also develops the use of lights, which is his great contribution to the Philippine painting. A glow against which figures are outlined, or at one point of the canvas, there is a generally burst of light that highlights the smallest detail. This is Fernando Amorsolo's afternoon meal of the workers. In my own interpretation, I think that the painter is trying to tell us how hard a life of a farmer is. Next is the Palay Maiden. Amorsolo's 1920 masterpiece, Palay Maiden, celebrates the Filipina in her own likeness, carrying new harvest to symbolize the hope of a rising nation. Next is the Antipolo Fiesta. In this masterpiece of Amorsolo, one would immediately notice the recognition and unity of the self with others, wherein a complete trust and bond between strangers who are obviously not of blood is currently unfolding. The culture of what others may liken to how life in the province is, and the advice that there is a great need for every Filipinos to learn how to makisama is also hinted by the abundance of food littered on the left corner. Through these paintings, we can able to visualize the events happened in the past with the combination of history and our imagination. These paintings should put more exposed to us Filipino, especially to the young ones. Because it's an eye-opener, making us realize that these paintings are national treasures. And for us to move forward as a nation, it is vital that we back ourselves with the riches of our past. And that's it for our video. Keep safe and God bless. And again, we are your fellow criminology students from Group 1. Mabuhay and thank you for watching.